Talk Sport Clips of the Week.
Well, kind of. The Clips of the Week. We'll have a regular batch, a fresh batch, on Friday for you. But these are from July 2003. We've been spinning the old Clips of the Week Wheel of Fortune at times over the last couple of weeks. They're normally around 2010, 2011. But 2003, to the point where they didn't even have a little intro on them. So I don't quite know how that worked. They're just the bare clips. So our producer has written some fresh intros for them. We haven't heard these clips. We're very much looking forward to it. I'll kick us off. And we start with Mike Parry and Graham Beecroft on the sad passing of a music legend.
And the sound of Barry White there. Sadly passed away, Mr. Snakes. Hips Parry already in action next to me there. But a very sad passing. I mean, he was one on his own, really, wasn't he?
When I was a youngster, Graham, that wasn't very long ago. You know, we used to rock and roll to Barry White in those nightclubs. He had the most fantastic voice. It was a compelling voice. Used to melt women's knees.
It's a very specific part of the body that used to melt, isn't it, really? Melt women's knees. Very interesting.
Here's Derek Thompson with news of a racing event.
And then running alongside, we've got this July Fair where you can go and see what old racehorses are doing.
Yeah, I wonder what they are. Old racehorses. Are they opening pubs? I mean, I don't know what they're doing. They're probably standing around in a field, yeah.
Basically.
What do old racehorses do? You're going to haulage, I would imagine, yeah. This is a very fresh-faced Alan Brazil introducing a bizarre guest.
Let's say a very good morning to Steve Knight, trustee of the Surrey Swan Sanctuary. Now, Steve, how safe are our swans?
How safe are our swans?
Good question, how safe are our swans? There's also one that
sounds about 12.
A swan guest on. It's very odd, isn't it? Really?
Wasn't there a thing at the time with the royal swans and people were trying to eat them? And
it could be.
Story?
Yeah, it could
I think
be.
It was. Something like that rings a bell.
Okay.
Anyway,
this is Richard... our swans. Yeah, come on, keep going.
No idea. This is Richard Kaufman trailing a big guest.
We hear from South African fast forwarder Sean Pollock ahead of tomorrow's One Day International with England.
Actually, the correction could have been worse, couldn't it, really? At least he got it right. Sean Pollock, he'll thank him for that. Back to Big Alan and Mike Parry being interrupted by a four-legged friend.
Yeah, Alan, sorry about that. Can you hear that crunching noise? I'm afraid it's our pet dog, Brandy. Brandy's our guide dog.
Yes. Alan, that's what Alan and Mike used to share, a guide dog. Our guide dog, of course. Yes.
Brandy the guide dog, not a pet dog, Mike. He was a feature around the office back in the day, although listening to this clip of Mr. Parry, there was something a bit unusual about him.
Producer, could you bring Brandy, the blind guide dog, in, please? I want some advice on interest rates. Thank you.
The blind guide dog. I mean, that is literally the blind leading the blind, isn't it, really? Brandy could very much see, thankfully, from Sean's point of view, whose dog it was. Here's the travel news now.
The M6 in Cheshire, we've got a smash, a multi-vehicle one, northbound at junction 21A on the approach to the Croft interchange. Now, it looks like we've got the inside lane blocked on that M6 stretch.
The phone started ringing. These things happen. Maybe there was a more travel news coming in. No, it's not a clip. That wouldn't get in now. But anyway.
It definitely wouldn't.
What's next?
It's Alan Brazil again with a text number.
Text the word breakfast followed by the answer and your name to 83088. Calls cost more than 50p.
Okay, that's a bit vague, isn't it? That's not about calls cost more than 50p. Could be about 10 grand a call. Yeah, bit of a chancer there. This is Chris Cooper.
The UEFA, FIFA, the FA, they've got to turn around and, if necessary, bite the ball by the horns.
Bite the ball by the horns. Oh, that would be bold, wouldn't it? I don't think I'd want to try that.
I wouldn't. It's Keith Arthur on Fisherman's Blues with news of a competition.
I've got to tell you, Mike, that for many years there was a John Smith's Championship on the Warwickshire Avon at Evesham on August bank holidays. Mm-hmm. And they really do push the boat out.
Well, I'd like to think so. It's a fishing competition, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's a nice way to describe a fishing competition, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
And sticking with fishing, here's the news.
Peacekeeping troops arrive in the West African country tomorrow. Dr. Henrique Steiger, a surgeon at the Red Cross Hospitals.
That's clever. Well, we know what old fish do. They become surgeons, but they don't know about old racehorses, clearly.
Now, this clip, this is station boss, our current station boss, and former Weekend Breakfast presenter Lee Clayton and Tony Cascarino welcoming a guest.
Victory yesterday for England against South Africa, and Jack Bannister joins us. Jack, good morning.
Lee, good morning.
Hey, Lee. Hi, Jack.
Tony says hello to everybody. Good old Tony. Here's the sports news now.
And in the men's and women's 400 metres hurdles, Olympic finalist Natasha Danvers again lowered her personal best.
She's delighted with that. Nothing like lowering your personal best. I bet there was a big celebration in the old Danvers household.
Yes, it's Beaky now with a guest talking about the weather and going full partridge.
I've been looking at your temperatures. It looks fantastic over there.
Yeah. Same applied to me yesterday, actually. I was not intentionally, but I was outside wandering around, went in somewhere where you could feel the aircon, you know, from about 3 or 4 yards away. So, oh, that's nice. I'll go in here. And it was quite interesting as well. Yeah. Anyway, there we go.
Wasn't really going anywhere, Beaky, was it? Really, the aircon anecdote.
I think we were supposed to go aha at the end of that.
I think we might have been. Yeah. Mike Parry now looking ahead to the 2003 Glastonbury Festival and running us through the lineup.
I've got a Radiohead CD. I'm going to dress it on the dining room table at home. I'm going to play it this afternoon and find out what they sound like, right? And then somebody called Moby, right? And is this something called the Pyramid Stage? There, Blue Zone, One World. Left Field, Purple Zone, Green Zone. Oh, no, sorry, that's where they're playing. Sorry.
Won't be getting his own music show anytime soon, will he?
It's brilliant,
Mike.
Isn't it?
Yes.
Is it me?
It's you, yeah, finally. Finally.
Yes, and finally, the Glastonbury chat continued with Mike and Al as they looked ahead to a guest.
Yeah, Glastonbury today. Our own Peter Abbott was there last night. We're going to speak to him a bit later. He's wallowing in his...
Oh, the wandering minstrel, the minstrel, the wandering minstrel who was in Australia, and I thought you were giving him the old elbow.
No. You've got the wrong man. No, Peter Abbott. That's Mike Bovill.
Oh, right.
He was the man
who
was wandering around Australia.
He's getting the boot.
Well, we haven't decided on him yet.
The classic Alan, who I think had a late night the night before. It sounded like, to me, didn't sound quite as youthful as he did in the first clip. So there we are. We can't do thank yous because it was 2003. But there we are. So that's some classic clips from back in the day. Apparently there's some more. So we will...
enjoyable. I like
this. We'll put those together for you, a few old names and faces you haven't heard for a while, and we'll give you another clips of the week.